Okay, let's brew this potion then. Do I keep putting that as the main quest?
Yes.
Got a potion for Lena. Swallow.
First sign of spring. Symbol of rebirth. Fitting as names go.
We'll see. Like I said, could harm her. Deeply. Works on me immediately. But I have a faster metabolism. Effects won't appear in her case for a few days.
Why'd you choose this in the end?
Decided it was better than doing nothing.
I like you, Witcher. Here. A small gift. For giving a damn.
Okay. Give me a bunch of shit. Of sweat and blood, a veil hangs between the world of men and the one beyond. This veil blocks the dead from the view of the living, and the living from the view of the death. Some mages can break through this veil and communicate with the Death, or else summon them to the world of the Sun for a short period of time. This is the art known as necromancy. The Death can also break through the veil and enter the world of the living on their own. Yet, unlike the necromancers, in doing so, they are not driven by reason and will, but by a thoughtless, irrational need. This need arises from powerful emotions, such as regret, longing, or wrath. Very often these emotions gain their power by being invested in a material object by the dead individual, while he or she still new life. The objects most frequent so endowed, wedding rings, favorite toys, or the instrument used for the crime which sent the returned individual to the other world in the first place. Okay. Interesting. Swallow. I actually got three. Let's put that there then. So you get several doses out of a single use or whatever. Alright, next quest. Collect them all now. Find the spirit that haunts the dwell. Okay. Why not? I'm going first to this place actually. so I want to read that notice board before I proceed with any more questing. Remember the dwarf.
What happened?
Yeah.
What do you
Easy on the insults. And he's
whole. No.
I can find your arse.
Alright. Yeah. They attacked him for being a collaborator, basically. If I remember correctly, retrieve this, this. In the end, I actually retrieve that one as well. Yeah. Alright, so let's do a bunch of side quests, as many as possible. Before moving to the Griffin. Abandoned village. Okay.
The infamous well. Strange, no sign of a ghost. Maybe it only shows at a certain time of day.
Be hilarious if this is a trap. Well, hilarious not for me so much. was actually wondering if Alcohol Thest was renamed in honor of Full Test. That could be the case.
Body's dried to a crisp. Signs of burns. Grass around the well scorched. All signs point to a new wraith. New wraith won't stray too far from the well.
Read the entry of Nundwraiths, why not? Very important location. First tab. Okay.
Whatever.
Nundwraith. Additional information. Whatever. I don't really care about those for the moment. Yarn and Yarn. Spectral and Moon Dust. Nailed by the well, the residents of White Orchard had suffered more than their fair share of misfortunes. Passing armies had trampled their spring planting, and Griffin had begun abducting their livestock, and the rotenizing on this painful cake, an unwraith haunted a nearby well. No wonder the locals called this final evil a devil. The Witcher could send something bound her to this place, and in order to send her off into the ethereal realms, he would need to find and learn her secret. Once that was done, he would be able to prepare for battle, and an unwraith is a demanding opponent. She can disorient her victim by blinding and creating mirror images of herself. These copies slowly suck their victim's life energy, while their mistress remains untouchable. In order to defeat her, the Witcher could not rely on his silver sword alone. The Yarden sign would also be needed to trap her and force her to take on a material form. Ah, that's great. Okay. Despite what is commonly thought, peasants do not interrupt their labors at midday to get out of the sun. They do it to avoid noon raids. On particularly searing summer days, when the sun reaches its zenith, raids will at times appear, resembling sun-scorched women dressed in long white robes. These are Nundwraiths, the spirits of young women and girls who died violent deaths right before their weddings. Driven mad with pain and anger, they wander the fields searching for the unfaithful lovers or bad-stained rivals. Though they will kill anyone who does not get out of their way in time, they are often hailed in this world by some object of intense emotional significance. That is why if one ever finds a wedding ring or a torn veil in the middle of the field, one should not pick up, but instead back away as quickly as possible. Nundwraiths are known to haunt rural areas and usually stay near the place of their deaths. They prey on peasants working in the fields and children playing nearby. Nundwraiths do not bleed and are one of the most immune to the effects of Witcher signs. They can create mirror images of themselves which circle their victims in a kind of morbid parody of a dance. This ghastly ritual drains their victim's life's energy while adding to their own strength. Nundwraiths are also able to manipulate the physical world to a limited degree, kicking up clouds of dust which temporarily blind and disorient their opponents. Nundwraiths can turn in material and are at such times very difficult to wound in order to force a Nundwraith to take corporeal form. One must first trap it with the Yarden sign or strike it with a moon dust bomb. Once the monster has regained physical presence, one can mount a fast attack with a silver blade or preferably one coated with Expector oil. Contrary to popular belief, noon raids can also encounter at night, but are much weaker than during the day. Well, then I'll fight it at night. Hello, fat boy. I died. Let me show you where I died. I died. Where was it? Around here, this location. I was hunting. I was hunting drowners to make that potion, the swallow potion for the girl. And I got hit in the back by one level 4 drowner and it killed me instantaneously. That was the first death, the only one. Hopefully.
Something's tied the Noon Wraith to this place, an object. Something she needs before she'll leave this world.
Let's see if we can find. I am concerned about the ability of that creature to surround me. You know? But if I cannot escape, that would be horrendous. I don't see shit here.
A man stabbed with a knife, died on the spot. Animals fed on his body, picked his skeleton clean. More blood stains over there, but it's not his blood.
A yellow diary. Find the spirit. Follow the drag marks using your witcher senses. Okay.
The journal might be useful.
Read the diary. Okay. Sure, why not? Diary, where is it? It's a quest item that makes sense. 27. Whatever. It happened. Bolker sent a petition of our grievances against the Lord to a court at Vizima. Listed all the harm he's done to us. How he killed Johan for not taking off his cap quick enough. How he trampled our fields with drunk with Aneri. With nary a thought of repayment, how he marched in during Peter's wedding and demanded his right of first night, how we have finally got what we begged Melitele for in our prayers so long. The judge recognized our grievances and waived all bonds and duties to the Lord. We can finally strike on our own. At last, we can live as free men. 12th, the 4th. The first day of our freedom! Okay. Hall's not much of a village yet, but to my mind it's better than the most fantastic place. Volker fumed our home with hazelwood smoke to drive out evil, buried a Martin under the gate to make sure no thieves cross our threshold, and then he gave me a bracelet, the loveliest I've ever seen. Mother said it's foolish to spend so much on a bubble. When we haven't plows nor hoes, and that we ought to return it to the merchant. Dead or my dead body, I'll never take it off. It will always be a reminder of Volker and of how happy we were that day. Okay. 23rd, the 4th. They say the Lord is coming to see us, that he wants to make a deal to beg us to return to the village. They say that he's calmed since his son died, that he's not as quick to anger out small slights. We'll see. One way or another, I have no intention to move one inch from here. I guess he burned their asses.
That bracelet might be what ties the woman's spirit to this place.
Definitely seems like it.
Bloodstains. Barely visible. Someone was dragged this way. Someone who was still alive.
How much do you want to bet? It's on the bottom of the well.
Palm prints in blood. Small hands. A woman's. Someone dragged her out. She was wounded. Fought for her life. No body in sight, but might still find some tracks. Under the right conditions, bloodstains can remain visible for decades. Another print by the well.
Well, I hope I don't get attacked. This is getting creepy. I also hope I don't have to go down there. Hey, Geralt. Stop being such an asshole.
Bloodstains. Almost faded. But the line's taut. Something's not right.
Yeah, the well is down there.
Hanged by the bucket rope. Woman the journal belonged to. Must be. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Need to cremate the remains. Gotta find the object that binds her to this place before I do, though. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Might be why her arm fell off. Gotta jump down there. Break my legs.
Are you serious?
Wide pelvis. Need to. Was she wearing? Gotta jump down.
I know you can die in this game from falling like a freaking idiot. What if I die? Okay, I'm going to say if I die from falling, I won't be restarting it. Okay, well that was lucky. So this is how wells actually work, huh? Couldn't tell you. I haven't seen an actual well ever in my life. Yeah, fat boy. I haven't seen a well in my life. A working one. I always assume it's yeah, not an underground lake or something like that, but rather a small bit of water that flows there. I don't know. Maybe I've seen too many movies. Let's explore the well before I do this quest. Who knows if the wraith will try to attack me down here. If it does, I need a way to escape. Shit, what is he doing? That's a dangerous thing. But if need be, I can retreat back here. Okay. Let's get that arm. Thank you. leave the cave. Okay. Guessing we will have to risk it.
Lucky not to come up empty-handed. A bracelet with an inscription. To Claire. From Volker. Bracelet must have belonged to the woman in the well. Lovely craftsmanship. But I'll have to burn it with the body to get rid of the noon wraith for good. Better do it near the well.
Okay. Let's hope I don't die. I have to dive again. Okay, what do I need to make a specter oil? Let's see. Cursed oil, what does this do? Attacked versus cursed ones, what the hell does that even mean? I need 10% Arinarius cursed ones. Fuck are they talking about? Alright.
Need to prepare for this fight. Brew some wraith oil. Drink some potions.
No, I'm not going to prepare. 10% damage is nothing, to be completely honest. It's extra damage, I mean. It's too little to worry about. I have already a healing potion ready to go. What I'm concerned is the fact that this thing could trap me. That's what I don't like. What if it is actually immune to Axie? That could be also problematic. Let's see. I'm going to run away fast into the woods.
And the bracelet. Igni.
Okay, it's summoned. Right, stint, yeah. So it's like Gwen. Thing is, my whole strategy is based on, let me show you. what I do. I thought the problem is actually following me around. I don't want to get trapped. That's what's annoying. To get trapped. Where is it? That's when they say it's ethereal. Okay. I prefer Axie because Axie stuns enemies. But it's true, that thing does not get stunned. So let's... So let's use Yard and then... This unstunnable. Let's see what Jordan does. It turns it. Okay, now I see why they say you should use Jordan. So Yarden makes her corporeal. This guy doesn't have the weapon. How can you use such a fucking moron? I don't understand why CD Projekt really did that. The unequipping of weaponry. It's completely ridiculous.
Gone. For good.
Okay, take a trophy from the Nunwraith. Nunwraith trophy. Return to Odorland for the reward. Okay. And I equip a trophy, like in the other games. Trophy. Trophies can be turned in for a reward. 5 bonus experience from humans and non-humans. Maybe I should have tried Quen. You know, maybe to see what it does. But it doesn't matter, I cannot damage it with its ethereal, can I? So I still need to make it corporeal anyway. What I like about Axie is the fact that it stuns and slows down opponents, fat boy. I would say that's why. Let me show you. I think maybe you were here. I have both Quen. I'm upgrading both Quen and Axie, but I prefer Axie because it minimizes my exposure during combat. If I can stun an enemy and attack it while it's stunned, then I'm actually not risking getting hit. While with Quen, I would have to be more aggressive, fight opponents that are. In fact, that's how I died. Hello Monty, no, I'm not using any mods or anything. This is just how the game looks on my computer, and it doesn't even run too hot. Dragon Age Inquisition really made my computer screech, you could say. This game looks as good, if not more good, and it's running perfectly fine.
Job done. The well was haunted by the ghost of a woman who was killed there. I drove it away.
I just hope every unburied wretch don't start haunting us. Well, that battlefield's gonna cause us a heap of trouble.
If they do, you know who to contact. Meanwhile, Claire, Volker, names ring a bell?
I don't know him. Though I did hear our herbalist Tamira mention a Claire once. Same one, maybe? Your reward, Master Witcher. The gold I'd hid away for Mandy's dowry. Without you, she'd never have lived to wed. Now, there's hope for it, at least.
Okay.
How about that? Never expected to get a dowry.
Nor did I suppose I'd ever give one to a witcher. Strange times these, wouldn't you say? Strange and sad.
I remember in Inquisition my GPU was running at 70 degrees Celsius. Right now it's around 50. Right, let's get another side quest. Why not? Let's do this one. You didn't take the coin? I always take coin. That's how I'm trying to roleplay Geralt, as someone that's more like a mercenary, you could say. A mercenary type. that doesn't have a heart of his own. He just wants to kill monsters and gain some coin. Maybe I should go and talk to this woman, not the other woman. You know what, let's do that before I forget. Well, if you... I can't actually make the voices... make the voices any higher. They are at the highest, Monty. The fuck? Where am I going? Yeah, let me show you. I think it's at max. Everything is at max. Maybe I could reuse the volume of the other thing, so voices seem a little bit higher. Well, 83 Celsius? That's really hot, fat boy. That would definitely burn my computer to the ground and make my energy jump. What the hell is this?
Yes?
Listen, ever heard of a woman named Claire? Lived around here?
Heard of her? A mild way to put it. Claire was a friend. The only person dear to me in all of White Orchard. Until her husband, Volker, quarreled with the Lord of the Manor. He then gathered the family, moved out into the woods to start a new settlement. The Lord and his retinue rode there to convince them to return. They were to be civil. No forcing, no bloodshed, but you saw. Word is Claire said something about the Lord's son, Florian. Something that made the Lord furious. But who knows the truth?
Lots of misfortune for such a small village.
'Tis so in every village. Even the smallest. You need only ask. But let's not end on a teary note. Here, a bit of solace.
One just appears and drops in bed out of the blue. Okay. Let's see if I got anything useful. Ah, so the NATTI actually, okay, give me a moment. I need to go. Give me a moment. Okay, let's continue. Sorry about that.
Man's large. Stinks of piss and vodka. Took off his boots and went in the water. Probably wanted to cover his trail. Lost his boots in the rush. Something jumped out of the rushes. Drowners. But he managed to escape. Bleeding, but not badly. Surface wound.
Me gran told me about Smith's boy. Lad went missing one day.
Tracks lead back to the village.
That was hunting nearby. Started poking him, asking. But he started twisting and squirming, so wham bam, they knocked his head off.
Aye, so it worked. Except it was some drowner that had sapped on the kid. Witcher?
Witchers!
What to do with it? What did the folk do? They could have sewed his head back on.
Word is, they laid his corpse to rest.
Trail ends here. But I'll recognize him by his wounds. Drowner claw marks. It's gotta be him. Nasty wound. Run into a drowner?
What the fuck do you care?
Whoa, our arsonist's a charmer, too. Come on, Smith wants to talk to you.
I ain't talk to a non-human. Sons of bitches all, and dwarves are the worst. Greedy little magpies, do anything for gold they will. They forge the blades the black ones put to our throats, am I not right? Listen. We can work this out, man to man. I give you gold, you don't turn me in. My mum died a while back and I sold her tools. I've spent some, but what's left is yours.
Fine. I'll agree to that. If you swear to stop playing with fire. Fail to do that and I'll come back, and someone will get hurt.
Of course, Master Witcher. I swear on me dead mum. Your gold. And here's to your health. Down with the black ones and non-humans alike.
Okay, now let's see if I can betray him as well.
Looking for trouble.
Who knows what the morrow will bring?
Couldn't track your arsonist down. Sorry about that.
Damn shame. Well, the black ones might catch him eventually. Do you need anything? I managed to save some things from the fire. And my anvil's whole. I could bang something out. You know, can use every copper now. A return customer. Welcome. What can I do for you this time?
Show me what you got. So long.
A return customer.
Like you to forge something for me. So long.
Come on.
Ah!
so I'll look for Bastion later, once it's safe.
Don't touch me!
Ow!
rest in later once it's safe.
Do that often? Talk to your dog?
It's my brother's, Bastion's. But I guess he's mine now. See, Bastion fought the Black Ones in a battle just outside the village. Haven't had word of him since. I told him, do like I did, lose a finger or two so they won't recruit you. Too damn afeard he was.
I'd walk the battlefield if I were you.
I did. Sea of corpses. And corpses feeding. Someone told me they were feared of fire, so I took a torch, tried to chase them off. Horse shite, I tell you. Would have ended up eaten alive if it weren't for Hussar here. Listen, guessing you carry those swords for more than show. Come with me, keep the ghouls off. Help me find Bastion and I'll pay you well.
Fine, I'll help you. Just been a few days since the battle. Chances we find your brother alive are slim. Very slim.
I would have thought, but I want to find his body at least. So Bastion don't rot there in the sun with the Black Ones. Meet me on the hill, overlooking the battlefield. We'll move on together from there.
So many corpses. The war's just started.
Somewhere.
Among countless others. Want to examine them one by one? Could take a while.
You needn't fret. The recruits from White Orchard painted a small flower on their shields so as to be able to spot each other in battle. There was just a few of them. We look for the flowers, we'll find Bastion quick.
No offense, but many a soldier's dropped his shield, especially if he was on the losing side.
If we find the shield alone, Hussar will catch the scent and lead us to Bastion. Come on. Sooner we get this done, the better. Doesn't look anything like him.
us all. Can you smell Bastion, boy?
Still nothing.
Come on, Asa. Can you smell Bastion?
I reckon this ain't a good time to chat. Let's do what we've come for and get out of here.
Skin's burned off. Might be hard to tell, I know, but could this be him?
Oh, yeah. Bastion was big, broad-shouldered. This one seems smaller, but maybe it's the fire did that.
He found him! Hassar's caught, he's sent! Come on!
More. My lieutenant demanded we defecate on command. Ballista bolts landing all around, and all he could say was, "A soldier with a full stomach will not step onto the battlefield." Now shit, that is an order. Can you believe it? The cretin.
Stop! You're killing me. My ribs. It hurts to laugh.
That needs a tourniquet. But first, want to explain what's going on here?
Bastion! Is he... Has this Nilfgaardian captured you?
No. He saved my life. I got a cut to me side. And then got hit in the head. Couldn't see anything. Rosin here found me as he crawled across the battlefield. His legs twisted. And so we were. Blind man leading a cripple. Found this place.
I'm taking you home. We need to see to these wounds.
I won't leave Rose in here. Alone he'll die. And he can't go back to his home. He's deserted. They'll hang him.
And what if they find him with us? They'll hang us all, my Laisha included. No, the Blacken stays here.
Your brother's right, Bastion. Nilfgaardians know no mercy. They live by their law. A law that's cruel as hell towards any who hide deserters or aid them.
Rosin, I'll bring you food. And an herbalist. You'll see. In a week or two, you
just go.
Thank you, Witcher. Your reward. And the gods protect you.
Come closer. source of power. It's gotta be.
Okay, let's test this random bullshit. I need to equip it.
Ghoul nest. Better just destroy it.
Awesome. Alright, let's go there. The ability point. So generous. Point it goes into. Now I see. I can only have 20 powers. Okay, not 20 points. I guess that's 4 times 5, so it's not all 20. Okay, let's put it into Quen, why not? Puppet. No, but that's a long way off. 1,000 experience. Alright, next place.
Shortcuts.
What do we have here? I hope it's not bandits. What do you know? It is bandits. At least one has a freaking bow. Okay, those archers are really annoying. He's fucking naked. What type of leader is that? He's completely fucking naked. Attack! Okay, this is clearly an upgrade. Switch those around. I really need to sell all that garbage. It's starting to clutter up. Hello, Kazan, how are you? Well, you want to get spoiled. At this particular moment, I'm not doing any quests. I'm just running around, discovering points of interest. But you might consider that being spoiled as to the contents of the world. But thanks for stopping by. I hope you enjoy the game immensely, because it is a very good game and the combat system is fair so far. You just need to, as always, find the way to cheese it. I think I found it. Okay, next stop is this one. Okay, thanks Kazan, have a good Friday. Okay, let's make sure I don't fall off. Die. Shit, here they come. Okay, a pack of wolves is an annoyance. Yeah. Prodromit. Everything works. Hello, Strix, how are you? Spice notes. Let's see. 15 days of observation. Ah, the same as Kazan. Yeah, okay. Thanks for stopping by, Strix. I'm sure if you play the game even at a slow pace, you will overtake me soon. Cause I play really slow, just like last. Due to trying to die today. But thanks a lot for stopping by. I hope I'll see you in the future. Back in the camp, brought in heaps of plunder, mostly armor and weapons, but this time a sealed chest too. Towards dusk, a man delivered rations of food and drink. 16 day. Messenger arrived in the camp before dawn, caused quite a stir. They immediately organized a group to transport the chest. After dusk, I'll try to track down where they carried it to. 17th day. Didn't move the case that far away, just to the abandoned hut near the old mill. Set up a watch so I wasn't able to get closer. 18th day. Every man in the camp has been drinking since yesterday noon. If we attacked now, we would obliterate them. Too bad the commander only sent one man to this outpost. I'll try to sneak in tonight. If fortune smiles on me, perhaps one man will be enough. But apparently, it wasn't. It's a freaking warg, isn't it? But it sure looks like one. Okay, let's go for this place.
Strange.
Strange. Okay, let's get out of that place. I don't want to talk to Esmir. Hello, Pacha. I would say the combat mechanics are really good in this game. It's fluid. And it's not cheap. It's actually based on, you could say, a close quarters combat as it would happen in the real world. Much better than The Witcher 1, for sure. It is an action RPG, no doubt about that. This one, I mean. The inventory. I would say the Witcher 1 inventory is far more realistic than this, but it's essentially the same. What is much more complex is definitely crafting, at least it seems to me. But the inventory is not hex based as in the Witcher 1. It's weight based as in The Witcher 2, but it's a minor change from what you experienced in The Witcher 1, to be honest. Okay, we're very close to whatever the hell this is. Okay, that's a ghoul. Only two ghouls easily dealt with. that's the extent. Although the lightning is not helping me that much. They blend in. Okay, I don't want to get in too close. Too close could be problematic. Although I only see the two. Bastard healed. Fucker jumped me.
Just destroy it.
Let's get this. Ready to point. Let's put it in Gwen. Actually, I spent a bunch of points I'm going to regret putting there. We shall see. I actually want to craft a sanum. I already have this item? Okay. If they say so, who am I to disagree? All consumed. To replenish your stocks, enter meditation. Really? That's amazing.
Damn, you're ugly.
Okay. I don't think there is any need. Some meditation, huh? Let's try that. I haven't meditated once. Let me check this. What would be my bombs? My Sanum bomb, for example. Where are they? If I have alcohol, he said, or they said. If I have alcohol, I should have alcohol. We'll replenish everything. Let's rest and see if that works out. Yeah, meditate, whatever. When you... Oh, 1 hour, yeah. Don't really care. Strong alcohol was used to replenish alchemy items. Are they serious? Yes, it did! Holy shit. That's powerful. Huh. That is amazing. Alright, let's go to the next location. Which is actually here. Okay, this is going to be a somewhat tough fight. Wait. Or not. Okay, disappeared. Okay, I have an ability point which I want to spend. Because I need to know something before I spend it. Going to close myself in here. I'm not an idiot. Okay. knighted, you fucking bastard. Chivalry gauntlets. Viper school, I think that's actually the school. Fuck. Fucking bastards. Okay, now I have killed it, actually. Definitely killed it. Medlina Blade. Okay. Seems to me like I've seen what's to be seen here.
Magic. A place of power.
So, what now? Another location. I would guess the logical stop is here. Because I actually need to sell a bunch of shit. So, let's go there. I'm actually no closer to leveling up than before. All right, but I got a bunch of shit. Let's see. The cavalry gauntlets. Bludgeoning and slashing. Okay, these are better. The Medlina blade. Prefer the critical chance, to be honest. Nobody got sword. Rindolf sword. Trick critical. That does a lot more damage. Hmm. Okay, let's switch it and I'll repair it in a moment. I need to sell all that garbage. This is going to be annoying. Prefer much more if they work where to attack me, so I have weakened it already. Stupid fucking poisonous gas. Let's go to the camp. It's a launch of crap.
Are you here to spy or haggle?
Show me what you're peddling.
Okay. Nice. I don't think I need to buy anything from him, to be honest. Can he craft something actually useful? Apparently not.
So long.
Stuck to this dude.
Need to ask you about something.
Yes? What?
So long.
Am I closing to learning up? Yeah. This lever closer to learning up. Okay. Let's save. Before I regret not saving. Next stop. This place.
Barbarians.
Barbarians. I wonder why people keep saying that Empire is much more civilized. Because the Northern Kingdoms don't seem particularly barbaric to me. They might be how can you put it? Far less refined, but that's motherfuckers. Why do I keep doing that? It's annoying. Okay, that's not on the map. Or is it? They cleared my marker, great. Ooh, what the hell is that thing? Gas, my ass. Fuck, are you serious? It returned. Okay. So, where am I? The toxic gas is really annoying. Lot of things. Ah, you know what I didn't do? I had to repair my weapon. That's something I had to, and I didn't do it. Because I'm an asshole. Okay, let's return to the Nilfgaardian. Let's find that. Pff, are you fucking kidding me? Okay. What is going on here? Seems like a serious fight.
Damn, you're ugly.
Actually, he's quite. Ah, fuck. Where is the archer? There he is. Fuck. Fun, my friends.
You're dead! Bring in your guts, Eddie!
Yeah!
can actually repair it with one of those things. I completely forgot. Look, how do you use this shit? What? Okay. So I can't actually repair my weapons. That's strange. Ah, because it's an armor repair kit, not a weapon repair kit. Okay. Sure, that's the reason. At least I repaired something. One of these days I'll have a crossbow and things will change. Until then, okay, then let's walk back to the fucking Nilfgaardian camp. Maybe I should summon that stupid horse.
Come on now.
We have much work to do here. Okay, let's send then this shit.
Plus 32 bludgeoning damage, okay. Hmm. sell this one, honestly. Not going to use it there. Let's stop lying. That's why I've...
Show me where you're peddling. So long.
I think I'm going to leave it here for today. Yeah, I'm also going to go patch. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. Tomorrow I shall start a little bit earlier and play for a little bit longer. So, thank you very much for watching, and I hope I'll see you next time when we hopefully will continue surviving. I think I will be able to hit the game without dying once. And without restarting again. Seems like a very good prediction at this point. Well, but I haven't fought a single boss, have I? So... until then, long live the Viper School. Goodbye.